So once again, hello dear students. Today we will learn about the improvement of the poultry. What is improvement? Improvement means to produce a generation with higher egg and meat production as compared to its previous generation. So it is called as improvement. So in modern poultry farms, successful management relies on accurate and complete dairy record keeping. Record keeping must be there. Without record keeping, you cannot say that whether your layer farm or broiler farm having higher performance, medium performance or lower performance. Some of the trait may influence the profit of farms. Trait means that economical section, such as production of egg, then production of meat, lower FCR, etc. They are called as traits, economical traits. So they may influence the profit of farm, thereby affecting the economics of the farm. Hence, they are called as economical traits. Improvement in this trait would increase profit of farm. So now let's see some of the important economical traits in which if we improve this trait, then automatically the overall profit of the farm will also increase. So first we will talk about the egg type chicken. We already know that the birds or chicken, they are raised for two purpose. One for egg production and another for meat production. They are also called as broilers. So first we will talk about the economical traits in case of layers or egg type chicken. So first most important economical trait, it is egg production. So if in your farm overall egg production is higher, then and then the profit will be higher. Egg production is result of many genes with appropriate environmental conditions such as nutrition, light, ambient temperature, water, free from diseases, etc. The many genes controlling all the process associated with the egg production can act to allow chicken to express its genetic potential. It means not only the genetic superior birds, but you also have to give them proper nutrition, light, housing, water, etc. for higher egg production. Egg production is influenced by mainly five factors, which are the first one, age at sexual maturity, intensity of production, or we can say rate of laying, then broodiness, then clutch size. We have already learned in last topic what is clutch size, then pause in laying and persistence of production. So these are the some five main factors by which we can increase the egg production. So friends, these are the formulas by which we can determine the egg production in any farm. Generally you will see this is managed by all the layer farms. So here you can find there are two formulas. One is for hen housed egg production per bird, but generally all the poultry farmers, they are preferring the second one formula. It is hen housed egg production in percent. So what is the basic difference between both these formulas are that the above one, it is give you production per bird, while the last one or second formula gives you the egg production in percentage. So what is this hen housed egg production? Hen housed egg production equals to total number of egg laid on a day multiplied by 100 divided by total number of hen housed at the beginning of laying period. So suppose today total egg production is 400 and at the beginning of laying cycle or in the beginning in the layer farm there were 500 hens. So hen housed egg production will be 400 multiplied by 100 divided by 500. So the answer will be 80%. So hen housed egg production percent can be 80%. So this hen housed egg production, time to time it will be goes lower. Why? Because suppose at the beginning we have 500 birds, but then there will be mortality of bird or death of the bird, which is normal, about 5 to 10% death per month will be there. So suppose in the second month or fourth month, out of 500, only 480 birds are there. So overall, the it will also affect the hen housed egg production also will be goes lower. Then another formula which is used, it is hen day egg production. First formula, it is for hen day egg production per bird, but generally the farm owners, they use the second formula, which will again same as the hen housed egg production. Here the hen day egg production will be given in percentage. So what is hen day egg production? Percent means total number of egg produced on a day multiplied by 100 divided by total number of hens present on that particular day. So suppose, as I said, today there was production of 400 eggs, but present day there is only 400 hens are there also. So the percentage will be 100%. But in case of, if we calculate the hen housed egg production percent, then what will be that? Only 80. Why? Because in the hen housed egg production, we divide by the total number of birds which were at the beginning of the farm, or we can say laying cycle. But in case of hen day egg production, we are dividing by total number of hens at only that present day. Suppose at the beginning there was 500 birds, but today there is only 400 birds are alive, hundreds are dead due to any reason. So hen, if you calculate hen house egg production, it is 80%, but hen day egg production, it is 100%. So always remember that hen day egg production will be higher as compared to hen housed egg production. And last one is average hen days. So total hen days divided by 100, total hen days multiplied by 100 divided by number of days. So total hen days means the days in which the birds have given the eggs. We have already learned in last lecture that for 4 to 5 continuous days, the birds will give eggs. Then there will be pause for 1 or 2 days, and again they will continuously give eggs for 5 to 6 days. So total hen days means out of the total days, how many days the chicken, or we can say bird, have given the eggs. So the total number of eggs given by a layer in continuous days, suppose one bird have given 5 number of eggs for 5 continuous days, so it is called as clutch size. So clutch size will be 5. So egg production, it is a lowly heritable trait. To produce hybrid cross having good egg production with higher egg weight, and one of the parent lines, usually the female, is selected for egg numbers, while males are selected for both egg weight as well as for egg production. So we all know that, okay, there will be mother and father, or we can say male and female both, for reproduction. So to increase the egg production in future generation, usually female are selected on basis of higher egg number, while the males are selected on basis of both egg weight as well as egg production. It means the males whose mother have higher egg and egg weight production was there, that particular males will be selected. Another factor which affect the egg production, it is age at sexual maturity. We have already learned in our previous course. So what is age at sexual maturity? It is defined as the age in days when the bird lays its first egg. Suppose in case of layer bird, the egg production start from 22nd week, or it is about 150 days. So it is called as age at sexual maturity. very early maturity is not desirable. Why? Because if the bird get mature earlier, then the eggs which they produce, it will be smaller in size. Also, there will be chances of uterine prolapse and other complication. While late maturity also, it is not desirable. Why? Because late maturity cause less number of eggs. Suppose one bird start giving eggs at 22nd week, while other bird start giving eggs at 32nd week. So egg production will be only for 7 to 2 weeks only. So if there is late maturity is there, there will be loss in egg production. So this is the reason in grower and pullets, restricted feeding and lighting is practiced. We have already learned during the grower management that in case of grower bird, only 8 hours to 9 hour light is given. Why? Because if you give light for 24 hours, the bird will consume more feed and there will be higher body weight. So it will increase the chances of early sexual maturity and there will be less small egg production. So this is the reason why in growers, or we can say in the pullets, there is restricted feeding and lighting is practiced. Egg jet sexual maturity is moderately heritable trait, ranging from 0.15 to 0.25. Then rate of laying, also it is called as intensity of laying. It also affects the egg production. This is important for annual egg record. This is the ability of bird to lay at a high rate at any given point or a period of time. Birds with high intensity of lay, or we can say high egg production rate, produce more number of egg per clutch, are better layer than the layers with fewer egg per clutch. It is also less heritable trait. It means what is clutch size? We have already learned that suppose one layer bird, it is giving 5 eggs continuously for 5 days, then there is pause for only 1 day, and again they will give the eggs continuously for 5 to 6 days. So they are called as higher egg production rate. So they are very very preferable for egg production, while other bird have only 3 clutch size. It means it gives 3 eggs for 3 consecutive days, then there is pause for 3 days, again there is production egg for 3 continuous days. So clutch size is only 3. So these type of birds that are not desirable for egg production. So higher the clutch size, higher there will be the egg production. So it is also called as rate of lay or intensity of laying. It equals to total number of egg produced up to that particular day or age multiplied by 100 divided by total number of days or age at present day. So here whatever the formulas are there, they are very very simple formula, just it is like trigonometry. Then broodiness, it also affects the egg production. When the bird is in brooding, they are not laying. Brooding means, we have already seen that broody hen, it means these are the particular layer birds which after giving the eggs, they will sit on their eggs for its incubation for 21 days. And whenever the chicks will come out or born from the eggs, again they will start giving the eggs. So it is called as broodiness. Hence, a minimum of broodiness is desirable. Mediterranean breeds such as white leghorn, Minorca, Ancona, they are non-broody. Non-broody means the female or hen of this particular breed will not have any instincts for incubation. It means the female of this particular breed, they do not sit on their eggs for incubation for 21 days, but they continuously will give you the eggs. So they are called as non-broody. While Asiatic heavy breeds such as our Kadaknath, Asil or Brahma, they are very very broody. So it means for 21 days they will not give any type of egg. So egg production is lower. English and American breeds are intermediate in the broodiness. this broodiness trait is highly heritable, so can be eliminated by selection. Broodiness has high negative correlation with egg production. So we have already talked that if the broodiness is or brooding period is longer, then the egg production will be lower. Why? Because during the brooding time, the chicken will not give any type of egg. So if the brooding period is longer, egg production is less. Modern commercial laying strains are avoid of this character. So generally these white Leghorn, which are most popular for egg laying purpose, they are non-brooding type. However, the broodiness and mothering ability is desirable for backyard poultry farming. Then comes the persistency. It is a measure of length of a layer. The laying is terminated at 72 weeks, called as laying cycle or biological cycle. We all know that the layer bird will start giving eggs at 22nd week, and it will give egg up to 72 weeks with higher rate. It will give eggs after 72 weeks also, but the rate of the egg per week will be very, very lower. So it will be not desirable to keep them for egg production. So after the laying cycle, the bird will enter into molting. What is molting? We have already learned that in this process, all the body feathers, old feathers are removed and it is replaced by the new feathers. In commercial farming, birds are culled after first biological cycle. So generally after 72 weeks, the layer birds with lower egg production, they are marketed for the meat purpose. The good layer molt late and rapid, while poor layer molt early with slow feathering. Fecundity terms as the total number of egg produced in a period of time, regardless other characters such as egg size, hatchability, etc. In a practice, it considered as pullet year. So till now we have seen the which factors which affect the egg production. Another economical trait, it is egg size. So if the bird have higher, we can say, egg production, but if the egg size is very, very small or too large, then it is also not desirable. It is measured in a term of egg weight. This is direct relationship between body size of bird and egg size. Eggs are smaller in the beginning of laying, then gradually increase in the size for 6 to 7 months. So we have already talked that when on the 22nd week the bird will start giving the eggs, it will be smaller in body weight or size, then there will be increase in the egg weight. The egg weight varies from 40 to 60 gram according to breed, strains and lines. Heritability of the trait is 50%. So improvement can be brought easily by selection. So if you select the females with higher egg production as well as medium to large egg size, then their future generation also will have higher egg production with higher egg size. However, it has strong negative correlation with the egg number. So selection must be careful in breeding program. So as I said, if the egg size is very, very large, such as 60 gram or 70 gram, then total number of egg produced by a bird in a week or during the whole 72 weeks, it will be lower. In crossbreeding, the pressure of weight, egg weight is given to the male line. So in crossbreeding, the females, they are selected for higher egg production and the males are selected for higher egg weight. So in this slide, you can see the standard egg size: small, medium, large, extra large and jumbo. So generally people prefer medium to large size egg, while small, extra large and jumbo are not preferred. Another important factor, it is egg color. So we all have learned about the different type of egg shell color in different breeds of different class. For example, the Mediterranean class chicken such as white Leghorn, they will lay white color egg, while other classes such as American, Asiatic or English, they will lay the eggs with brown color shell. The cross between them will produce tinge or light brown cell color. Cell color in Andalusian chicken is blue. To evolve a white egg layer, the common breed used it is white Leghorn. For brown eggs, the breeds like RIR, Plymouth Rock or Hampshire is used. So it is upon the poultry farmer okay, how or which type of egg he wants to produce. If he wants to produce white eggs, then he will go for white Leghorn, and for brown eggs he may go for RIR, Plymouth Rock or New Hampshire. So in this slide you can clearly see different egg colors such as chocolate marine, then in case of Leghorn, Hamburg and Campine white color, then Australope, RIR, Brahma, Orpington, they have brown color eggs. In case of Oliveger, you will find the green color eggs. So another important factor, not only for egg production but also for meat production, it is feed efficiency. Also it is called as FCR, feed conversion ratio. So what is this FCR? FCR means amount of feed taken by a bird for production. Suppose one bird take 4 kilograms of feed and produce 2 kilograms of body weight. So FCR will be 4 divided by 2. So FCR will be 2. While another bird is there, we take only 3 kilograms of feed but produce 2 kilograms of its body weight. So FCR will be 3 divided by 2 equals to 1.5. So whenever the FCR is lower, it is more profitable. FCR is lower, it is more profitable. So in commercial layer, FCR for per kilogram of egg mass production and of a dozen egg, it is around 2.53 to 1.7 respectively. Measuring feed intake per bird is difficult, so selection for breeding on this basis is impractical, because here you can see that there are hundreds of birds within a farm, so it is not possible to calculate for the feed intake or how much amount of feed taken by a particular each and every bird. Both egg production and egg weight have high positive correlation with feed efficiency. So selection on this trait will improve the feed efficiency. So if the feed efficiency is better, or we can say FCR is lower, then it is more profitable. Next one is body weight. The body weight at maturity or at 20 weeks as well as for adult or 40 weeks are significant in the layer breeding. The optimum mature and adult body weight for medium type egg layer, it is 1.2 to 1.6 respectively. It means the ideal body weight must be 1.2 kilogram at maturity or 20 weeks, and it must be 1.6 kilogram at adult age, or we can say at 40 weeks. Selection of population for breeding for ewe egg weight tends to increase the body weight of future generation as they are positively correlated. Restricted selection index is used to check any untoward change in the body weight. Then egg quality traits. Egg size and egg weight does not only dependable, but egg quality also is very very important. Egg quality characters such as egg cell thickness, albumin index, hog unit, blood and meat spots are lowly heritable trait, so they are not included in selection program. Cell thickness is the only trait having economical importance and is negatively correlated with body weight or egg weight. It means if the egg weight is higher, then the cell thickness will be lower and chances of spoilage of egg is higher. So this is the reason why medium egg size is preferable, because in medium egg size you will find proper cell thickness, so the shelf life of the particular egg it will increase. Then viability, or also we can say survival rate. most serious problem in layer farming is the mortality among pullet. Mortality rate means the rate of death of bird out of total number of birds. Suppose there are 100 birds are there, in 1 month the 5 birds are dead. So mortality rate, we can say it is 5%. Both genetic defects and infectious disease cause the death of the birds. Gross genetic defects are usually eliminated, because genetic defects we can eliminate by proper selection of parent stock. However, efforts are required for breeding and selection of strains which are resistant to disease. So it is very simple, such as the crops, variety to variety we will produce a new crop, or a crop, new variety of a particular crop with higher disease resistance power. So same is applicable here also. Selection of strain with resistance to disease, it is also very very important. Mortality in case of growers 5% and in pullets 3% is allowable. So it is ideal mortality rate, because it is not possible that there will be not any type of mortality. Mortality will be there, but the ideal rate that in case of grower it must not be more than 5%. In pullet, it must not be more than 3%. In layer stage, mortality rate will be only 1% per month, and it is desirable. So, how you can calculate the mortality rate? It is again very simple. Mortality in percent equals to number of chicks died multiplied by 100 divided by total numbers of chick born. Suppose, also we can calculate in such a way that we have purchased 100 layer birds, out of this 5 are dead, so the mortality rate we can say it is 5%. Then fertility and hatchability. It is difficult to distinguish between low fertility and high incidence of embryonic death. So it means in case of fertility is lower, then there will be high incidence of embryonic death will be there. So there will be not any type of chick production will be there. Therefore, fertility and hatchability of fertile eggs are usually considered together as hatchability of eggs. Heritability of both traits is very very low. So here you can, how you can calculate the fertility percent and hatchability percent. Fertility percent equals to number of fertile eggs multiplied by 100 divided by total number of egg set. Suppose we have in incubator we have set 100 eggs, but out of 100 eggs during the candling time only we can see that 90 are we can say fertile. So fertility rate will be 90%. Same type, how we can say the hatchability? Hatchability is calculated after completion of incubation period or after birth of the chicks. It means number of chick hatch multiplied by 100 divided by total number of egg set. It means suppose we have set 100 eggs in the incubator, after 21 days 80 birds or chicks are produced. So hatchability is 80%. So always hatchability will be lower, slightly lower as compared to fertility rate. Then sex linked dwarfism. We all know that dwarfism means the body size and also the body length, it will be shorter as compared to average body size. Dwarfism, which causes an animal to be smaller in size, it is very very common in chicken. Hence, that carry the sex linked dwarf genes are about 1/3 smaller than normal birds, but their egg size is only 8% smaller. So the layers or the hens which have this symptom of dwarfism, it will have 8% smaller eggs as compared to normal birds. In this type of layers, there will be lower body maintenance requirement and increased FCR. So these type of birds are not desirable for profitable egg production. So in this picture also you can see, in the A you can see they are the dwarf birds, while in case the B they are the normal birds. So till now we have seen the how we can improve the egg production in egg type chicken. So already we have talked that the birds are raised for egg as well as for meat purpose. So now we will see the important traits by which in the improve of that particular trait we can increase the profit. So meat type chicken, it is also called as broilers. So in broilers, most important trait is body weight, at market age or body weight. So what is broiler? We already know that broiler are the birds which are raised only for 6 weeks or up to their body weight is 2 kg, and then they are slaughtered for meat purpose. So it is more desirable that this 2 kg of market weight it reach earlier. So it is very very important. Other traits are body conformation, hatching egg production in percent in breeder line, etc. In broiler breeding, the female line should be one which produce high number of chicks or with high hatchability percentage. Compared to layer, the broiler breeding much easier because selection for reproduction can be done at earliest 6 weeks of age. So why? Because at the 6 week, whatever the birds are there with higher body weight, they are selected for reproduction. And why? Because the future generation of their particular birds also will have higher body weight. So it is more easier in broiler production, while for egg layer production you have to wait for 72 weeks. So first important economical trait, as I said, it is body weight. Why? Because if body weight is higher, then the higher there will be the income. It is the most important trait in broiler production, and it is highly heritable at marketing age. Therefore, it is relatively easy to make genetic improvement in broiler by individual selection. It means the birds, out of 100 birds, the birds which are higher body weight at 6 weeks of age, they are only selected for future reproduction, whether they are male or female. So selection is very very easy. It is positively correlated to the body conformation, feeding efficiency and dressing loss. Hence, if the growth rate is improved, other carcass quality characters are also improved. However, body weight is negatively correlated with the egg production. So as we have already talked in layer, okay, that if one hen or layer have higher egg higher body weight, their egg production will be lower. But here, the higher the body weight, there will be higher carcass weight or meat weight. So it is more desirable in broiler. So here you can see in this chart, okay, due to future selection, now we have got such a famous strains of the broiler bird which will produce 4.2 kg of body weight at 56 day old. Here you can see during the 1957, at the age of 56 days, it will have only 0.9 kg body weight. In 1972, it was only 1.8, while in 2005, now if you raise the broiler for 56 days, it will give you around 4.2 kg of its body weight. So here you can see, due to the proper genetic selection, we are able to achieve so much higher body weight birds. Another important factor, same as the in the egg production, it is feed efficiency or FCR. In modern farming, a feed efficiency of 1.6 to 1.8 is achieved at 6 weeks. Measurement of individual feed efficiency is difficult to measure, so it is not included into the selection program. So as I said, I am saying that FCR is lower, it is more better. Selection for growth rate automatically increase feed efficiency, as they are highly projective correlated. It means if one bird consume only 3 kg of feed and produce 2 kg of body weight, it will have only 1.5 FCR, and it is very well desirable. So again, how you can calculate the FCR or feed efficiency? It is amount of feed consumed by a bird multiplied by 100 divided by total body weight gain in that period. Suppose, as I said, in the 6 week period, the body weight increase is 2 kilogram and the feet taken is 3 kilogram. So the FCR will be 1.5. Another important is meat yield, because broilers are only raised for their meat. So if in the body meat weight is higher, it is more desirable. It is expressed as the carcated or dressing percent. So what is this dressing percent? So dressing percent means out of the whole bird, only some muscles are edible for human consumption. So the body weight of the particular body muscle or body organs or part which are used for human consumption, it is called as dressing percentage. So कोई जो पूरा बर्ड होता है ब्रॉयलर बर्ड, वो हम भी जानते हैं, वो पूरे पूरा ह्यूमन कंजप्शन के यूज में नहीं आता. उसके फेदर्स निकाल लिए जाते हैं, उसका हेड निकाल लिया जाता है. सो उतना ही बॉडी में से उतना ही पोर्शन जो ह्यूमन कंजप्शन के लिए कंज्यूम होता है, तो उसको हम ड्रेसिंग परसेंट बोलते हैं. इट मीन्स टोटल वेट ऑफ ड्रेस्ड कार्कस डिवाइडेड बाई टोटल वेट ऑफ बर्ड मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 100. सो इट विल गिव यू द ड्रेसिंग परसेंट. So, dressing percent, yield of specific carcass part and yield of specific tissue such as lean, fat, skin and bone. Meat quality can be expressed by several methods such as by carcass conformation or grade, sensory evaluation, flavor, juiciness, tenderness of cooked carcass or meat or its part, and by chemical composition of the carcass to determine the amount of protein, fat, ash, moisture, etc. So here it is again very simple formula for dressing percent. Dressing percent equals to dressed weight multiplied by 100 divided by please slaughter live weight. It means dressed weight means ke only the edible part will remain. All other bones, internal digestive system, heads, shanks, that are removed. And the remaining body, it is called as dress carcass, and the weight of this particular dress carcass, it is called as dressed weight. So suppose the body weight, living body weight was 2 kilograms, but the dress weight is 1 kilogram. So we can say dressing percent is 50%. But generally you will find in ideal broiler, there will be 60 to 70% dressing percentage will be there. Again, same as the egg type chicken, viability or longevity. In commercial broiler farming, under standard management, mortality rates of 3% and 2% is allowed at starter and finisher phase respectively. It means during the first 3 weeks, there must be only 3% mortality rate, and during the last 3 weeks, or we can say from 4 to 6 weeks, there will be only 2% of the mortality is desirable. Mortality in broiler involves mainly the diseases such as Pullorum, Coccidio, Newcastle disease or Ranniket disease, etc. Then another important trait is body conformation. It includes breast angle, keel length, shank length, breast milk yield, abdominal fat percent, oval or appearance, etc. This trait improves when the stock is selected for body weight, as both are positively related. It means if the body weight is higher, there will be higher body conformation. The abdominal fat percent will be higher, meat yield will be higher also. So if the body weight is higher, overall body conformation will be superior. The ideal meat bird having plump body with a long, broad and heavily fleshed breast. So in case of body meat of the bird or broiler, breast muscle, they are very very important. So if this muscle are more developed, then or they have higher weight, then it is very desirable. The back must be broad with minimal fat. If the breast is low in fat, it fetches high price than other meat cut. So breeders are selected with higher percent of breast muscle yield. Then skin color. Skin color is also preferable because it is mostly the people will prefer yellowish to whitish color meat. The skin color is inherited, where white color is dominant on yellow color. It means generally you will find the meat color or the muscle color, it will be slightly whitish as compared to yellowish. The common breed used in evolving commercial boilers such as Cornish, Plymouth Rock and New Hampshire, they are yellow skin. So developing a yellow skin boiler is very very simple. For developing white skin broiler, you can use Sussex breed, can be used for breeding program. So it is again up to the farmer. If he want to produce the birds with yellow skin color, he will go for breeding with Cornish, Plymouth Rock or New Hampshire, and for white color it will go for Sussex breed. So here in this picture you can clearly see there is white chicken as well as the yellow chicken. Here also you can see the sank colors. Generally the sank color is not that much important, but in some countries they are using the sank also for human consumption. So in that countries it is important. So here you can see, you will find several colors in the sanks also of the bird, such as white, yellow, straw, willow, black color, blue or slate color. Then comes the plumage color. Plumage color means the color of feathers. Both melanin and carotenoids contribute to the plumage color of the bird, but it is the mainly the melanin that determine plumage color and pattern in domesticated fowl. So in commercial birds, both melanin and carotenoids contribute to the plumage color, while in case of our domestic fowl, only the melanin determines the plumage color. We have already learned in Kadaknath breed. Kadaknath have black color meat. Why? Because of the deposition of melanin. It is also called as fibromelanosis. Colored plumage have disadvantage. Why? Because the pin feathers and pillow plumes gives unpleasing appearance to the dressed carcass. Pin feathers of white plumage bend with carcass color. Pin feathers are feathers which are rarely early stage of its growth and yet to erupt from their follicle. So what are these pin feathers? Pin feather means it is very very small and they are at early stage of their growth, that they are not erupt from their follicle. So pin feathers kisko bolte hai? के जो फेदर्स अभी तक बॉडी में से बाहर नहीं निकले, बट वो अपने ग्रोथ के अर्ली स्टेज में है. सो इफ दे आर व्हाइट इन कलर, दे आर डिजायरेबल. व्हाई? बिकॉज अगेन मोस्टली द मीट कलर विल बी व्हाइट, सो वो उसमें एक हो जाएगा. लेकिन इफ द प्लूमेज कलर इज डिफरेंट, सच एज ब्लू और ब्लैक एटसेट्रा, सो व्हाट विल द इट विल गिव कलर पैटर्न टू द स्किन और वी कैन से मीट ऑफ द बर्ड, एंड इट इज नॉट डिजायरेबल. So generally for layer farming you will find the farmers generally go for the white feather breeds. So here you can see different plumage color in Asil, then light Brahma, Leghorn. Leghorn is completely white, so generally it is broiler production. Here also you can see different the plumage colors. Then rate of feathering. Slow feathering birds have large number of pin feathers. It means, again as I said, pin feather means they are the feathers which have not erupted from the body, but they are in early stage. So the bird with slow feathering, they will have large number of these pin feathers. Early feathering is one of the desired characteristics in broiler, avoiding problems of pin feather at the time of processing. So if there is early feathering is there, so what will happen? At the 6 weeks, all feather will be fully grown and it can be easily pull out from its body. So early feathering, why it is desirable? क्योंकि early feathering से क्या होगा कि जब तक वो 6 week का होगा तब तक उसके body पे जो भी feather है वो fully grown हो जाएगा. So जब हम उसको slaughter करेंगे तो feathers उसकी body में से निकालना बहुत आसान होगा, एंड पिन फेदर्स भी कम हो गए, सो इट इज मोर डिजायरेबल. रेट ऑफ फेदरिंग इज इनहेरिटेड बाय सेक्स लिंक्ड dominance in white slow feathering dominant over fast feathering, making all lines involved in crossing as homozygous recessive for rate of feathering can ensure this character in all progenies. So selection must be there. Only we will select the birds for reproduction with early or fast feathering, so that their progeny also will have fast feathering or early feathering. Then fertility and hatchability. All reproductive characters like fertility and hatchability are lowly heritable. Both these traits are less important to broilers as they are negatively correlated to body weight. We all know that the broilers are only raised for meat purpose. We are not producing eggs from the bird, so they are less important. English breed Cornish is common male line in broiler breeding. Though this breed is good in body conformation character, reproductive traits are lowest. Therefore, special attention has to be given to improve the fertility in breeding program. So for the production of the broiler bird, their parent must have higher fertility rate and higher hatchability. Then and then there will be higher number of chick production will be there for broiler production. So friends, here are some of the questions from this topic for your self-evaluation. So you have to write down the answers of this question and you have to submit back within 2 days. So thank you friends. If you find any difficulty, you can ask at any time. Thank you.